There it goes. Oh, there it is.
Hey folks, Johnny Corthius here. I've found myself all the way in Isny, Germany at the EDELRID headquarters. I'm here to shoot some content for their knowledge base. Specifically right now, there's a major topic of conversation in terms of rope abrasion resistance. We want to see how much of an influence our climbing technique really has on exactly that. Here's Daniel, let's get to it. Hey buddy, good to see you.
Good to see you,
let's
man.
Let's get to it.
Yeah, that's number six.
All right, so here we are.
Yeah, I think you know the test tower.
Yep.
We worked here before. And you see the rockage over there on the platform.
Awesome.
The best setup, so we have some meters below on which we can work.
Awesome.
And then I think we can change more or less all the parameters that we want. We can change the angle
yep.
we work.
We can trade out ropes, different techniques from the bottom.
We can also add different rope lengths before the corner. Before
right, because we can easily just redirect or exactly. just fix in the corner.
So
I love it.
We easily have 20 meters in front or 2 meters in front.
Beautiful. Cool, man, let's get to it.
Okay. There it goes. Oh, there it is. You can feel it start and then obviously all goes.
All right, so for these tests, we wanted to set up some parameters so that we could isolate the variables and figure out exactly how much of an impact my climbing technique was going to have on the rope and the effect that that edge was going to have on the rope. So on my end, I had to choose between one of two ascent systems. One was pre-threading the rope through the descender and ascending using the hand cruiser and a foot loop. The other method was using the chest ascender with a hand cruiser and a cowtail like you normally would in ascent mode for rope access. So using both of those, I also climbed the rope very hard, so really dynamically with poor technique, and then I climbed it how I normally would in the field, relatively smooth and monitoring sort of my own rope climbing technique. And the results were crazy. That said, those weren't the only parameters that we set up. Daniel and all the camera guys up top, they had their own plan. So if you don't mind, maybe walk us through everything that was up there.
So we defined that we want to climb 5 meters.
Yeah.
So this is the distance that we want to measure.
Mm-hmm.
And then after the 5 meters, we would examine the rope on the edge. We also defined we want to run the rope at an angle of 30 degrees over the edge. And we defined that between the edge and the anchor point, we want to have 20 meters of rope. So we have some dynamic, some stretch between the anchor and the edge.
Makes sense. All right, so obviously we started out when we just shortened our terminology. So anything with a 1 was pre-threaded through the descender, and anything with a 2 was in normal ascent mode. Okay. And then we had an A series of tests and a B series of tests. A being really dynamic using poor technique, and then the B using more of an elegant, usual sort of, softer technique, exactly. So here we are, all of our broken rope. We've got it arranged in the order that we tested it. So 1A, 1B, 2A, 2B, 9mm with 1A technique.
Exactly.
And then Interstatic ProTech 1A and here 1A. Okay.
Right. So this is 1A, mm-hmm. and you can see sheath is broken, and it broke after around 3 to 4 meters.
Right. Yep. Right here, the full 5 meters, the rope is in great shape. I would still like totally run this.
2A, then different setup, but same technique.
Same technique, poor technique,
exactly
3 meters, it's gone. And here we go again. Slightly worse, but still totally usable.
So conclusion is that as here, the behavior is the same, here the behavior is the same. So the system that you're using, almost no impact on the abrasion resistance of the rope, and the technique has high
impact. Right. Now moving into 9mm, within 3 meters, we broke the sheath.
Exactly.
And then just to see, we went a full 20 meters and it broke on the 20th meter.
Copy. I got you.
Right. Absolutely.
Right. And we did the same thing with 11mm, but it didn't actually fail. We only went, we went through 25% of the core strength.
Exactly.
Okay. Interstatic, 5 meters. Still in great shape. And finally,
this was the 11 millimeter again.
Yep.
not with the 20 meter of
right.
the rope.
Just fixed.
Exactly. It was 3.5 meter between the anchor point and the edge.
Yep.
And 20 meter of movement. But yeah, sheath broken definitely, but way less damage than...
Yeah, point loaded all the stress.
Exactly.
Roger that. All right, so in the beginning, we set out trying to figure out if our technique or if the system had a greater impact on the abrasion of a rope. And we learned one thing for sure, the way you move on a rope matters more than the system that is on that rope.
Absolutely.
Right? Your technique is gonna have more of an effect on the rope, for sure, especially when it's going over an edge. Now, obviously, we should talk a little bit about ways that you can prevent this from happening. Right? So if there's no way to avoid the rope coming in contact with the edge, either temporarily have that occur and then re-anchor so that you're close to your work without the rope being under tension on that edge, or install rope protection, right? And if you're in the industrial environment, you just do not proceed with your work unless you have a way to protect that edge. But sometimes that just isn't reality, especially up in the alpine.
When you're outdoors, sometimes you can use the soft protection in case you have it with you. In case you don't have it with you and the rope is running over the edge, the easiest way to deal with that is to bypass the rope on the edge, to fix a sling before the edge and below the edge on the rope and load the sling and not the rope. So in case you climb up the rope there, the sling might be damaged and you might have to retire it afterwards, but your rope still is absolutely fine.
So thank you very much for having me out to ISNI.
Tony,
this was such a pleasure.
Coming around.
Yeah, and I guess we'll see you guys on the next round.